What I probably know that Nairobi Federation is dealing with complex issues. As we also deal with the complex issues to our own context, like dealing with the low-income people that we're dealing with, dealing with the rural dwellers, mid to be perceived to urban dwellers, and engaging in policy issues to Kisumu is one thing. To Nairobi, it's kind of obvious. It's a practice. They have engaged a lot, but for Kisumu, there's need for sensitizing people to know what are these policies, how do they translate to their daily life, what wants to let them participate and engage. But for Nairobi people, if anything just come up, they respond to it immediately. And like they have the whole knowledge of it at their fingertips. The other thing I can compare with Nairobi and Kisumu is about urban development agenda. Nairobi and Kisumu being declared a city, and Nairobi is also a city. We all city counties. We could probably borrow even more entirely the NCBN's Nairobi and implementing Kisumu without fear of contradiction. Because we'll say if it happens well in Nairobi, like the rail relocation option plan works well in Nairobi, why don't you work in Kisumu and we are classified as a similar city? So those are actually what I can borrow as in similarities. But there are a lot in terms of socioeconomic, Nairobi is a little bit high. In terms of cultural engagement, Kisumu is a little bit high. In terms of what I would refer as an endpoint engagement, Nairobi will engage at a middle level or starting point engagement. And in Kisumu, we do what is called endpoint engagement. Like, this is my home. I'm building my home. I'm doing it for my home. Then every person will say, I'm doing it for the urban dwellers. I'll one day leave this place to my rural home.